Hello, here is the review of my Lemorele dual protocol M.2 enclosure. Dual protocol here means it supports both NVMe and SATA. I paid about £8 for this in a sale. As you can see, these are sold out now. Perhaps I got the last of them. You can see it's clearly advertised as supporting NVMe and SATA, as well as various lengths and keys. I tried searching for a similar product and this turned up. It appears to be their new revised edition with the same exact components, except there's some ambiguity about whether it includes the JMS 583 or an AM 8180. The aperture that contains the drive is still oval, unfortunately. It's just a lot thinner. So, saving their money and it's the same price. A JMS 583 would probably represent a small downgrade from an AM 8180. If you search AM 8180, you'll find a post on Anantech where someone by the name of Zextos has confirmed that the firmware is identical to the commonly deployed RTL 9210. RTL 9210 often appears in single protocol NVMe drives without explicit SATA support. I wonder if dual protocol is even worth mentioning in an advert these days, since NVMe is supposed to be backwards compatible. I have an RTL 9210 enclosure, I should perhaps try it. Anyway, the drive here comes in a substantial hunk of aluminium with thermal pads. Quite how the flat SSD is supposed to mate, even with thermal pads, to the oval aperture in the aluminium shell is beyond me. Here you can see the date of manufacture. It's August 2021. That's 2 years ago. You can see the start of the bridge chip is AM8. Let's begin testing with a simple crystal disk mark run. The enclosure contains a 512 gig NVMe disk. In crystal disk mark, that shows up as 477. As the tests progress, I monitor the case temperature, anxious that the thermal pads included are only optional. In the background is Windows' disk management. The Lemorele is disk 1. I attempt thermal imaging of the drive, but the only heat is coming from the screen behind. I've sped this up many times, now back to 12 times. In the background, watch for disk 1 disappearing mid-test. I didn't notice this at first. The drive would also have disappeared from Windows Explorer if I had a window open showing that. In my ignorance, I attempted to recapture the last row of tests. Disk capacity insufficient. It appears that there is no disk. Alright, on with the teardown. Sliding the drive in and out was difficult, thanks to the rubber grommets provided to keep the PCBs apart. Rubber below and above the drive, especially above, was rubbing on the stationary part of the case. A couple spare screws for the collection, do nicely on a GPU fan. These clips were trouble, I had to pause and think. Rather than forcing each apart and using a third hand to lever out the PCB, I found purchase at the PCB end that the screws were removed from, and I could pop each latch individually. I need to change lens now. AM8180B with no cooling. That's the white tip X. It comes off easily enough. Underneath is the XMC QH32 BHIC. It's a 4 MB EEPROM. That's NOR flash with a retention expectation of 20 years. The drive is invisible to Windows now. I got a full refund, but I submitted much more video than I've shown here.